deliver us from the love of Christ. Will Lord. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are countless to the slaughter. No, in all these things, our comrades love us.
Our second scripture lesson is taken from the book of Lamentations, our first But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy is ever cultivated. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, said my soul. It is good to those who wait for him, the soul that seeks him. It is good to watch him for the salvation of the world. The Lord will not reject forever. The Lord will not reject ignores nor denies suffering, but confronts and deals with it head on. And honestly, which one knows? A little background information. When ancient Israel united monarchy divided in two, the northern kingdom retained the name Israel. South to the name Judah. Long after that fateful story, northern neighboring Assyria invaded and broke out Israel. More than a century after that, Judah will instantize at the hands of the Babylonians. Total devastation of Judah took the best and brightest. So the seaboard center of the was the name that Washington, D.C., and every synagogue, temple, and mosque. The dregs we left behind are no way for us to grasp Judah's ruin. It's through a fictional perhaps Hollywood portrayal of some apocalyptic to threaten the brother of Lamentations is not confined to this tale is a timeless metaphor of all types of suffering and speaks to anyone across the ages who is utterly hopeless and deceased in words. Most of you listen to this foundation. It's a written book. It is the book of how. The book of how, as in God. How did we get here? One arm, bewildered, and wide arm. Ow! So, what's the worst thing that you can imagine happening? Attack that changes how we live and survive. A cancer diagnosis. Breaking trauma. A crippling what is that ultimate tragedy? I asked that question because I think it was great. With those situations, the ones in my Lamentations is by definition a complaint, a protest. It is also a search for meaning. When our life's dream is transmogrified into a genuine nightmare, we can question it and doubt it's acceptable to God. Think about the person who's 40 years old. Maybe he knows his doctor was the best worker ever. What is the best position for him? It's not here or here. What is that beloved doctor? My love for you has never been greater. So the doctor must have more to heal you because it's so hard. You expected God was well. The diverse voices God is faithful toward us. God loves us. We are blessed. We are the greater. Our well-placed hope is a truly wise decision supported by a God whose hopes for us will be revealed to our children.
of pain, not a magical cure, not a 180 degree turnaround of life's fortunes. Because God's providence is not only linked to physical and material blessings, as we often believe. God's providence is a steadfast love that never ends. Mercy is God's eternal love amid tragedy's pain and suffering and aggravation and complaining and doubts and anger. I may have nothing except God's love. In the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Somewhere.